Hi, my name is Brian McElligott, and welcome to my studio. We're doing something a little different today. We're actually making this little video using a 360-degree camera. So what I would suggest, if you have, if it's available to you, watch this on Google Chrome, and you'll be able to take your cursor and click anywhere on the screen and drag it around. And you'll actually get a 360 degree of the studio, which is kind of cool. The only drawback with it is we've had some problems with sound quality, so that's why I'm using this handheld mic and feeling kind of silly. But that's all right. So anyway, I guess I'll first just talk for a minute about my current painting. This one here, it's tentatively called Oatsy the Iceman. It's the story of the Neolithic mummy that was found in 1991 in the mountains on the border of Austria and Italy. This mummy was so well preserved, they were able to determine what he actually had for his last meal approximately 8 or 9 hours before he died. They were able to tell that he carried a copper-bladed axe, a partially constructed bow made from yew wood. He had arrows. He had a fire making kit. He had a bear pelt hat and a grass woven cloak that was actually a waterproof cloak. And they even reconstructed his shoes at one point. And the fascinating thing to me about what else they discovered was they examined him for a number of years, and then eventually they discovered that he died from an arrow wound. And they discovered this because they found an arrowhead embedded deep in his back under a shoulder blade. And from the forensics, they were able to determine that a wound inflicted by an arrow at that location would have been quickly fatal. And so that was certainly his cause of death. It's possible he was trespassing on another group's hunting grounds, or perhaps he had stolen something. These are all just theories that the scientists have come up with about Oatsy and what happened to him. Anyway, I love history. I've been doing a lot of winterscapes, and I like the mystery that this painting can kind of tell a little bit of that story, but still have some mystery to it. Over here, if you look where I'm pointing, that's another one of the winter scenes I've been working on. That one is Hannibal crossing the Alps. Next to that here is a work in progress called The Siege. These are all just working titles. You never know. If we look over here, this is a painting about a character I've done a few times. He's a bit of a time traveler, and he shows up in different places in my paintings. This one is a bit of a mystery, I hope, but he is he's kind of looking around at a place that's been abandoned for reasons unknown, and he's just trying to figure out what might have taken place at this certain location at different times. Over here is a painting called The High Ground, another winter battle scene. Over here on the Big Easel is a part of a series I've been working on, tentatively called Icarus, or The Icarus Project. Who doesn't love the idea of having a personal jetpack where you could actually fly? And who hasn't at some point in their life dreamed of flying like a bird and with that kind of freedom? So I've done a number of paintings with these flying characters, and we may do something with that, turn it into a little story down the road. We'll see. Anyway, just feel free to click around and look around the studio. I've got some other little works of mine spread out. You also might see some pieces by other artists you might be familiar with. Got a nice Jeff Menges painting up there. Got my Donato drawing of Obi-Wan. Nice painting by William O'Connor. We picked up these all at IlluxCon. Also over the mantle, there's a little piece by Jeremy Wilson. Next to that, a little drawing by Linda Adair, and a Richard Hescox little science fiction landscape. These other paintings you'll see of like samurai figures, those are mine. Again, part of an ongoing series I'll probably talk more about in the future. Over in the corner here, there's a cool little airbrush by Joey Fallon. Nice guy too. Anyway, just wanted to give you a quick tour of the studio. Oh, before I go, don't let me forget my awesome Frank Frazetta print, which I've had for a little while now. It's a signed print from the man himself. It was a huge inspiration and one of the reasons I have become a painter. So that's it. Again, just feel free to click around and hope you enjoyed this little tour. We'll see you again soon.